See, in this point 32, I am going to give you different statements related to the functions, okay? Different laws you may say. For that, initially we need a function f, which is a bisection also. See, that f just connects set A to set B such that x connects to y such that y is equals to f of x. This y is equals to f of x is the rule. That rule is already given, okay? And IA is the identity function, just it connects x to x. IB is an identity function from set on set B. It connects y to y because y is an element of B and x is an element of A. Now first thing A, what I am going to discuss is, see, as we know, f is a function from A to B. F is a function A to B, as we mentioned, x to y, that is equals to f of x, okay. F is a function from A to B. IB is a function from B to B, is it right? F is a function from A to B. IB is also a function from B to B. And we need to think about IB circle F. And we need to think about IB circle F. It is a function from A to B. And it is a function from B to B. And what you say about IB circle F? Just like G circle F, right? Since this is same, the codomain of F and the domain of G, there is a chance to define this IB circle F, and this IB circle F is again a function from A to B. And how it connects? It connects an element X. X is an element of set A, and this IB circle F connects X to, don't say it as Y, because the rule is IB circle F. We need to show whether it is Y or not actually, okay? See, it connects an element X of A to an element of B, and that element is simply IB circle F of X. You just think about it. This is the definition of the function, and that's why, as per the rule and as per the notation, this function connects X to IB circle F of X. I don't know whether it is Y or not, and I need to check it. See, IB circle F of X is simply nothing but IB of F of X, and that is equals to I suffix B of F of X is what? As per the definition, F of X is equals to Y. So this is Y. And that IB of Y is simply nothing but Y. So actually IB circle F connects X to IB circle F of X, but that IB circle F of X is simply nothing but Y. So therefore, what I am going to conclude here is, just have a look. F is a function from A to B. IB is a function from B to B. IB circle F is a function from A to B, and it connects X to Y. So therefore we have two particular statements. IB circle F is connecting A to B, okay, such that IB circle F of X is equals to Y. And already we know about F. F is connecting again A to B such that F of X is equals to Y. When you observe these two statements, the domain and codomain are same, as per that the rule is also same. So we can conclude it like this. IB circle F is equals to F. F and IB circle F are equal functions. See, I is an identity, right? We are just applying identity to F. So when you apply identity operation on a set, on an element, it gives us the same element, right? And that's why here again we have that IB circle F is equals to F. See, just have a look. Just we proved that IB circle F is equals to F. Okay? This is first bit A. And in the same way, in the next part, we need to think about F circle IA. Okay? First of all, you just have a look about this. Okay. So, F circle IA is equals to F, I need to show, right? So, first, I need to make F circle IA. So, first of all, you just consider IA. IA is from A to A. Okay. And what you say about F? IA is from A to A with that particular rule. F is a function from A to B. So IA is from A to A, F is a function from A to B. Then what you say about F circle IA? Then this F circle IA is simply nothing. But this is A to A, this is A to B. Since A is the common here, so directly we will connect from the first set to the last set, A to B. So F circle IA is connects A to B, and an element X of A 2 f circle ia of x. Just look there. F circle ia is the function, okay, and this function connects every element to 2 f circle ia of that element. Okay, you don't say that element as y directly. We need to show that as y. We need to prove it as y, and that's why initially you just take that element as f circle ia of x, and that is f of ia of x. And as per that identity definition, identity element connects x to x only, so that ia of x is x, so f of x. And f of x from the definition of f, and it is y, so it connects x to y. So at the end, what I have? I have that f circle ia is a function from a to b such that it connects x to y. So it is just similar to this f, which is connecting a to b and x to y. So this f circle ia is equals to f. That's it. Okay, so this is another thing. And the third part, what I am going to prove is I need to think about f circle f inverse. Okay, so for that, first of all, f is from a to b, so first of all you just identify f inverse. Since f is connecting a to b, f inverse will connect b to a, and since x is connecting x to y, so this f inverse connects y to x such that x is equals to f inverse of y. So this is the definition and notation of f inverse. We are all very familiar with this f inverse and notation as well as f notation. I need to think about f circle f inverse. Okay, so I am erasing this, and then I am thinking about f circle f inverse. Okay, so very simple. F is here a function from a to b. Okay, f inverse is what? F inverse is again a function from b to a. F is a function from a to b. F inverse is a function from b to a. Since this b is a common thing, so we have a chance to connect this f inverse to f. Okay, but here, okay, no problem. F inverse circle f. Okay, f inverse circle f is a function. Since this b is the same thing, we need to connect from a to a. F inverse circle f is connecting a to a. Again, we know x is an element of a, and this function connects that x to f inverse circle f of x. This f inverse circle f connects x to f inverse circle f of x. So that is f inverse of f of x. And what is f of x? F of x is y. So this is equals to f inverse of y. And as per the definition of f inverse of y is nothing but x, right? So this is equals to x. So at the end, what we have? F inverse circle f is from a to a such that x is connecting to x. And that's why what I need to conclude at C? I need to conclude that f inverse circle f is equals to ia. Just we are equalizing the functions, right? This is f inverse circle f, and that is equals to ia. In the same way, if you think about f circle f inverse, then it will become ib. Okay, I think you are all know about the definition of f inverse. Just it is the inverse of f, right? Okay, so in the same way, if you connect d, you will get that f circle f inverse is equals to ib. The proof is very similar for this f inverse circle f is equals to ib. Okay, just have a look. At the end, we need to memorize all these things. Okay, different laws related to a function along with the identity functions. Ib circle f is f. If circle ia is f. F inverse circle f is ia. F circle f inverse is ib. No need to memorize, but whenever the situation comes, you just analyze it. Okay, don't memorize, you just analyze. On you see, with analyzation, easily you will answer all these type of questions if you have. Okay, just have a look.